The arugula, baby arugula.
I'll eat that.
Because we need greens in it.
Mustard. No, none of that.
No
mustard.
I might wait.
Once it cooks, because it fluffs up when it cooks.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why break them in half.
Oh,
you know,
wait a second.
Instead of
look in there.
Instead of long words.
Colin. My cannabis gummy. Is it this one?
That's my mama.
Just enough. Check it out.
Perfect. Yeah, we only need a little bit.
Just enough. Alright, and oh yeah. I'm not too buzzed. You what?
Trying to wrap this so nothing gets in it.
My mom.
Oh, look at you! Look at Rhett! He's trying to reach backwards. Oh my god, you're nuts, dude.
I'm gonna borrow one of these and do this different stuff.
He wants to work out.
Totally nuts, Rhett. Yes, you are.
Oh, he's got a coffee thing.
You're a funny dude.
You know, French vanilla cup or something. Coffee creamer. That's what he has. Coffee creamer. Coffee creamer.
What's up, Brad? What's up, buddy? They're actually very, very, most of the world, most of the world thrives, and even part of their economy is on bugs.
Yeah.
Ooh, and scorpions.
Do you, I draw the line. No, you know what? Honestly, I draw the line at mealworms.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Have you ever eaten mealworms?
Yeah, I have.
They taste like nuts. Do you know the proper way to do it?
It's actually, they taste kind of like a raw noodle if you're chewing on it.
Do you know the proper way to cook them? Like the correct way to cook mealworms?
I've eaten them raw.
Prepare them? You've eaten them raw?
Wow. Just like worms. Just like grubs.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's gangster.
Lizards.
Beetles. Beetles, rats. Not,
rats.
Muskrat. Muskrat.
Muskrat? Oh, those had to be cooked too. We boiled them.
That's, man, crazy. You gotta be, when you prepare them.
Oh, snake.
I
is my favorite.
I have learned that when you prepare any type of wild creature like that, like a muskrat, like this rat, like a rat cat. What's up, rat cat? What's up, buddy? You loving that toy? You loving that toy, buddy? Let's see.
So, lizards, you usually want to cook them. Don't eat them raw because they can.
Yeah, it can come back to, like rawness. Right? Like snake, you have to eat snake quick because it comes back. It comes back raw. Yeah. So you have to prepare it correctly, cook it correctly.
You have to cut off about that much away from its head if it's poisonous.
Wow. That's probably where the glands are.
Yeah.
Wow. I was today years old when I learned that. Yeah. What I was going to say is, like, muskrat, you have to watch out because you can't cut the, what is it, a castor sac?
No, that's not a muskrat, that's a beaver.
A beaver.
If you cut the castor gland on a beaver, then your meat is spoiled from it. It's ruined.
Oh, so can you eat?
It's the worst smell.
So can you eat the caster?
I mean, you could.
You okay? So what do you do? You
can eat it, but
you it's cook. Good. So what do? You cook the entire thing, I'm guessing, and then you not fillet it off. You just cut around it, like maybe
a
quarter inch away from
what
it.
What you do? You skin the animal.
Yeah, all obvious.
You skin around the genitals, you cut off the castor glands, and then you pull off the rest of the hide and pull the legs out, pull the arms out, and then pull it down through the head, and then you pull it off the head. Cut off the head, you cut straight down the middle, you gut it carefully so you don't cut open any urine sac, so you don't cut the guts to get poop on it. Yeah. On your food, okay. After you do that, you reach inside and you pull all the guts out, heart and everything.
Yeah.
After you pull them out, then you get in there with water and I think my mom used to use vinegar too sometimes, but get in there with water and just like scrape around, get out all the excess like connective tissue stuff that held in the guts and all that.
Yeah.
Clean the butt area real good where you cut it off.
And you
cut off the legs or the hands and the.
You gotta go through how long in hours does that take?
And then,
or if you're good, minutes.
After that, you cut it from the ribs and this piece. You cut it there.
Yeah.
To separate the bottom half from the top, and you throw them in the boil.
Oh.
And eat them.
Oh, but so you rip off past, like you dissect, like
you have to cut
maybe a half an inch, maybe like a half an inch away or something. Does it bleed a lot?
Yeah, there's a lot of blood.
Wow.
A lot of blood. Sometimes you accidentally cut a bowel, you get shit all over you. You don't want to do that though.
Yeah.
That's why you have to cut carefully. So when you're going up the belly, you don't go straight down. So you come from right here.
Yeah.
And you cut slowly up this way. When you're going through the belly, you want to pull up when you're cutting slowly as you tear through. And if you don't come out of the skin completely when you're doing that, you just come up a little bit, turn your knife like this, come up a little bit, and you're just really carefully pulling out the skin off of the gut area that holds, kind of like a sac that holds in your guts. And then you pop it open basically and pull it out.
Wow.
Yeah.
And then how long do you boil it?
Not very long. I don't know. I think I would boil it probably like 30 minutes.
That's it.
Maybe an hour.
Maybe an hour.
If you want more cooked.
Maybe about.
You don't have to boil it that long. It cooks pretty quick.
I would be in there with a biotherm.
If you were frying it, you'd want to fry it for a pretty long time.
You want to, any of that type of meat, you honestly want to cook until it's at least 165 degrees. At least 165 degrees on up to like 180, and you're good. Like a biotherm is the fucking grail. You know?
If I had one, I could do it and show you.
Yeah. No, I here's the thing. It probably would be the same.
Like
because you're boiling it. You know what I mean? But you have to, once you put it in, it's going to bring down the boil, and then it's got to boil back up again. So it takes a while, and you got to have a big ass pot too, huh?
No, actually, a muskrat is about this long, that wide.
Really?
Yeah, they're pretty small.
Wow.
A beaver, though, can be like this wide and that long, and then the tail extends this long.
Yeah.
So, like, a beaver can be like from here to the ground with its tail.
Wow.
And they're like that big.
Wow.
They're fat.
A beaver.
Yeah.
What is a beaver?
And they have these huge long teeth. They're about, they stick out of their mouth like that long, and then they're about this long up in their mouth. And then they're all super yellow.
Really?
Yeah, from chewing wood.
Oh, wow. A beaver. I bet a beaver doesn't go down easy.
They also have webbed feet.
How do you catch a beaver?
A trap. Okay, so if you catch a beaver, you're gonna do it in the water. And what you do is set up two sticks, basically. They're block ways. And this is to the hole in their dam. So you you get in the water with waders on.
Don't do
it. You bring your trap. The trap is square. It's usually square like this, kind of small, and has these little sides. It's really easy to set a beaver trap. And you squeeze the sides and it opens it up. So there's two flaps here and there's two flaps here. And so you open it up all the way down to here. Once you, basically, you're opening a square and turning, folding it down into a square that's facing a different angle. And so then you turn it sideways and it's set. And when it snaps, the edges, this side is kind of coming out like butterfly wings, but both sides. And when it snaps, this side closes, the other side closes at the same time. And so it gets caught in the front and here. Yeah. And, or here and here, wherever it hits. Wow. And so what you do, you put two sticks, whatever, thick enough so it can't go through, on the sides of its den so it can't go around the trap. Yeah. You put the trap as an opening to its den hole. And you have a wire attached to the trap with a chain bringing it all the way down and attaching to a stake that you stick really hard into the ground so the trap can't go away. And then as it's coming through, it doesn't see a way through both sides because the trap's set and the sides of the traps also stand out and block just like the sticks.
Oh, wow.
And so it goes through and snap.
Yeah.
Got it.
Wow. You know what? That's so fascinating, and I was 2 years old when I learned all that, and I'm a relic. That's so fascinating, dude.